Welcome people, WildChild82 here, and today I'm going to show you a new product from the well-known company Retrobit. It's a company from China that has made a lot of retro controllers in the past. This time it's a GameCube controller, because nowadays you can play a lot of GameCube games very well. Because there is an emulator called Dolphin, and it's available for the PC as for Android. The PC version is a little bit better developed, but I'm sure in about 1-2 years it will also be very well playable on very good Android devices or telephones that are powerful, like the Samsung Galaxy S8 or the Huawei M10 Pro. Because those devices are powerful enough to run these games very well on 60 frames per second. I've got this controller in the mail from the company Mindscape. Mindscape is a Dutch company that sells consoles and games and also retro stuff like this. So really a thumbs up for them for sending this product to review. And I'm very curious how well this controller is. Because also this controller has a very unique design. So I like it a lot more to play GameCube games with this controller than on a standard Xbox or Shield controller. So let's look at the back of the box. Also nothing too special, only what's inside the box in different languages. Well, let's unbox it and see what's inside.
And here is the product itself that came inside the box. It really just looks like the original GameCube controller from Nintendo. But this one is from Retrobit. Ooh, it feels really nice. Ooh, this is very clicky. I like it that it is responsive, because on the original one you hardly feel if you press it down. But this is a little bit noisy in my opinion. These buttons feel really great, just like the original. Also, this is made of rubber, so a very good grip. The R and L trigger are very hard to press. A little bit too hard in my opinion, but I don't know if you notice it when you play games. The build quality is really nicely done. Yeah, and here you see a comparison between the original one and the Retrobit version. Yeah, they look identical, and the controllers in front, all these buttons you see here are identical. I don't feel any of hardly any differences. Also the thumbstick, it's identical. The D-pad, it feels identical. Really, it really is. What does not feel identical are the buttons at the back. All these three buttons feel totally different. I really didn't like these R and L. They are too clicky and too loose in my opinion. And the Z button doesn't give any response. You don't feel if you do something when you press it. That I never liked as a kid. Yeah, they change it, but not of the better, because these are actually a bit too tight. It's really heavy, and I think if you play for a long time with a race game like Crazy Taxi, I think your fingers get really tired. So that's also not very great. And this is responsive, but it's very noisy. But still, I like this better than this. But that is maybe a personal opinion. Now let's see what the weight is of the Retrobit GameCube controller. It's around 170. So it has a good weight. And I think that the original one is a little bit heavier, but not by much. And as you can see, it's around 200 grams. So it's a little bit more, but not really that much more. So it's good to know that the weight is around the same. And yeah, you really got the feeling that you have something legit in your hands. So that's really nice.
Now let's do some gameplay. I'm playing with the emulated Dolphin on my personal computer. Let's see how it works. I did have the sound removed because of copyright issues. So, and yeah, it feels great. It's a very nice emulator. I can really recommend this because it plays a lot of GameCube games without any problems. Yeah, really nice. Let's try another game. Let's try out some Soul Calibur 2. Knockout. I really like this game, played it a lot back at my childhood, especially the Dreamcast version. It really feels great. Next game, I'm going to play some Super Mario Smash Brothers, a very nice game. Oh. Already a knockout, that's really fast. And also if the stick is too sensitive, you can also change the sensitivity in the emulator itself, or you can create some dead zones in it and just adjust the stick so you think you like it the most, or you feel like it plays like the original one back at the days. So that's really nice. I'm now playing just at normal settings, and the stick is a little bit more sensitive than I can remember, but still it plays really nice. It's also very nice that you can play all these GameCube games on the PC and later also on the Android device, because there are a lot of nice Wii and Wii U and GameCube games, and Dolphin is a really nice emulator. And most games also are in 60 frames per second, a lot better than on the original hardware, so it's really cool. As you can see, it plays really nice and I'm kicking their butt. And there goes the last one, and I won again. Next game, and now I'm going one of my favorite SMAP games, Igaruka. Very nice game. I originally placed this on the Sega Dreamcast and later on the GameCube. It got a small glitch in the video, but maybe I can adjust that. I just play now with the original Dolphin settings. The game itself runs very smooth. As you can see, the controller is really responsive. So so far so good. No complaints at all.
Now I'm going to play some Crazy Taxi. And with this game you need the R and the L buttons. And yeah, as I mentioned before, they are quite heavy in my opinion. So if I play this game a lot, I think that my fingers will get a little bit tired. But yeah, they respond well. That's not the problem. I played this game a lot on the Sega Dreamcast. A very nice game. Woohoo! This game goes so fast. I think my stick is a little bit too sensitive at the moment in this mode. But you can adjust that in the emulator. That's no problem. But yeah, still it plays very well. So yeah, it's very nice.
Time for the final conclusion.
And what do I think about the controller?
Yeah, the controller is very fine. The buttons here on the front, all of them feel exactly the same as the original one. Echt, really, you don't feel any difference. So that's very good. So it gives you the really feel back at the day. On the buttons on the back, it's a different story. The R and the L are too tight, in my opinion, too heavy to press. And this one is a little bit too clicky. It's good that it has some response, but the sound is a little bit annoying. But on the original one, these are too loose in my opinion. And this one, you don't feel if you do something. And also, I don't like these. So make something in between and I'm happy. The build quality is the same as the original one. It's very strong, It's a very good build quality, and I think you can play a lot of hours with it without breaking it. Yeah, overall for the price it is 20 euros. Yes, it's really worth the money. Also, you've got an original version which has the original connector from Retrobit that you can put in the GameCube. And that one cost, when I made this video, only 12.50. On the Mindscape website, so that is really cheap for such a good product. And I can really recommend those guys, because they got excellent customer support, they got a nice website, and if you live in Germany, in the Netherlands or in Belgium, really order your stuff there. They sell a lot of these controllers and other stuff like consoles and games, modern games. So yeah, I will put the description below the video. And I can really recommend everyone to buy this controller if they want to experience their childhood again. Or maybe, you never played GameCube games and you want to play them. Hook up a PC of hook it up on a PC or Android device. Install Dolphin. Download the ROMs. I can't say where you can download them because it's illegal. So, I want to thank you for watching. And don't forget to like and subscribe. Until my next video. Bye bye!
Hi fellow YouTubers, I want to thank you for watching and don't forget to like and subscribe to my channel. Yes, and you also can follow me on Facebook, Twitter, don't give a shit about Twitter. But Instagram, I make pretty picture and I send on Instagram. So yeah, follow me.